In 2016, I was at here that CRISPR Cas9 was used to inactivate oncogenic mutation in 2016. And in 2017, first time used the CRISPR Cas9 successfully modified the beta globin gene mutation in human embryos to overcome the most severe disease, sickle cell anemia. And in the recent year, 2020, the Nobel Prize in Chemistry been given to Emmanuel Carpentier and Jennifer Doudna for the development of a method for genome editing. So this all about was the history and evolution and the milestone achieved in the CRISPR-Cas9. Now, what is this mechanism naturally or synthetically or in vitro what we are using? So in the natural system, we'll see this is a bacterial cell. So there is an invasion of viral DNA. So the virus will attach to membrane, it will release the DNA, it will invade the DNA. After the invading of DNA, it will integrate with bacterial chromosome in CRISPR locus. So CRISPR locus, there is certain spacer sequence, which we call pre-CRISPR RNA in CRISPR locus. So following this guide RNA will form, this guide RNA will be attached with tracer RNA, activating RNA. In that form, it will form single guide RNA, which will bind with Cas9 complex, which is inactive before this. And after binding with this guide RNA, it will active. And after activation, this guide RNA with Cas9 complex, it will inactivate the invading DNA. So what actually happened here, the viral DNA will come. It will release the DNA, viral DNA. Bacterial defense system will active. Once it will recognize the invading DNA or viral DNA, the defense system will active. How it will active? It will recognize the PAM sequence there and GG sequence. So protospacer adjacent motif is there, PAM sequence. Those PAM sequence will recognize by guide RNA, and at 3 base pair up the stream, this guide RNA will bind, and with the help of Cas9 nuclease. So this is type 2 Cas9 system. There is lots of Cas9 till 13 is existing. Now 3 is in common use. Cas9 is the type 2. So in the type 2 system, this Cas9 will be active, and this Cas9 nuclease at 3 base pair up the stream of that protospacer adjacent motif, PAM sequence, will chop up the viral DNA. And after that, there will be certain repair mechanism. So two type of mechanism is there, homology direct repair and non-homology end joining. How that will occur, that is in next slide. So this is the natural CRISPR pathway. So the idea of CRISPR-Cas system arise at this point, when this viral DNA will come, this bacterial system will detect it as a foreign DNA. So the same approach we can use, we can incorporate our DNA along with this DNA, synthetically we can design. And at that reason, we can create some indel mutation, some knockout study, or whatever type of study editing we want to do. So this is natural CRISPR pathway. Now this CRISPR-Cas technology, so when viral DNA will come, we have provided some foreign DNA, after that in the form of guide RNA. So at that target region, we will design the guide RNA. That guide RNA will bind at the complementary region. This guide RNA are the complementary region of target. So there RNA DNA duplex, heteroduplex will be there. This DNA RNA heteroduplex will be recognized by Cas9 nuclease, which is the RNA third type nuclease. So in the recognition of this, it will chop up the DNA. After that, it will follow either non-homology end joining pathway or homology direct repair pathway. In non-homology joining pathway, वी कैन प्रोवाइड सम डोनर डीएनए और इट कैन बी रैंडमली हैपन. सो देयर विल माइट बी एरर प्रोन रिपेयर इंडेल म्यूटेशन कैन क्रिएट और प्री मैच्योर स्टॉप कोडन. द प्रिफरेबल विच वी वॉन्ट फॉर अवर स्टडी होमोलॉजी डायरेक्ट रिपेयर वेयर वी विल प्रोवाइड अ रिपेयर टेम्पलेट सो प्रिसाइज जीनोम एडिटिंग विल बी देयर. What is the mechanism in this binding in the complex and like when we can provide the DNA, when we cannot provide the DNA? So in guide RNA binding, there are two complex, this Cas9 nuclease and the guide RNA along with target complementary region. So suppose that in a gene somewhere in middle or in a pristine, we want to create the mutation, some deletion or some insertion, something. So this guide RNA, what it will do, it will bind with the RAC1 and RAC2. There are two domains which activate the Cas9 nuclease. So this RAC1 and RAC2 domain will bind with Cas9 nuclease, and that RNA guide RNA will be active at this position with complementary region. So these two domain will activate the RUBC, which RUBC is a nuclease which initiate the cleavage of DNA. Remember, RUBC is a nuclease which initiate but not cleave. RNA's H or this Cas9 nuclease is there, which impart in the cleavage or in the chop up of target region. So I will repeat this part. Like we have a target complementary region. We have designed the guide RNA. Our guide RNA will be there inside the cell. It will bind with target complementary region. That time RAC1 and RAC2 will activate the Cas9 because there is a foreign invasion and we need to activate the Cas9 nuclease. So RAC1, RAC2 will activate, and that time RUBC will initiate the cleavage process. So that time Cas9 will cleave. Which region it will cleave? Where the PEM site is there. The role of RAC1 and RAC2 is too important. Like if RAC1 activity will be eliminated, that time Cas9 nuclease will not work. And if RAC2 will be mutated or activity will be eliminated, that time Cas9 nuclease may work or may not work. But if RAC1 activity is eliminated, that time Cas9 will not work. So this is the process of guide RNA binding and the cleavage of target region. Now when cleavage will occur, that time two type of repair system will be activated, non-homology end joining and homology direct repair. So if there is no donor DNA, that time gene knockout will occur. So some region might remove or it may not remove. Both chances are there. Like blunt end will be created and it can join directly. So gene knockout might occur or may not occur. But if we have provided some template, donor DNA, so there is a probability of gene insertion. But keep in mind, this is a random phenomenon in non-homology end joining. So this also may occur or may not occur. But in the case of homology direct repair, which is a regulated phenomena, there will be donor DNA present. So if we want to correct, like gene corrections is there, that time that particular template we can provide. Or if we want to insert particular DNA, that time also we can provide the template. So the role of this template is, like suppose that if you want to make a 12 base pair deletion, so design a like 100 base pair nucleotide domain and create a 12 base pair deletion there. So when it will bind, and remember it will be complementary of bacterial DNA sequence. So when it will bind, that time 12 base pair deletion will be there. So there are these mechanisms, and after that, taking these things in concern, we can design our SP. So not in a like thoroughly, in a small way, I have kept this study. So for designing your study, firstly, we need to set a target that where we want to do, whether in a gene therapy in a human or in a mice, like any gene knockout, insertion, deletion, or in cells. The cells, it is common, and secondly on mice, and the third in gene therapy. Other way also there, like some if someone wants to do study on the plant as well, So those target also there, and others also there, like if you know, to cure the to diagnose this COVID as well, there is Faluda kit was designed. So it depends what kind of work we want to do. So before starting our experiment, what things we should have over in hand or in mind or on paper, those are like type of mutation, what kind of mutation we want to do, whether insertion or deletion. Host, the host will be whether cell, mice, or human, or some insect, or whatever you want. Vector, it also play a major role that which kind of vector you want to use for study. Single guide RNA, this can either we can design manually or we can synthesize or we can order by the company. Single strand DNA nucleotide template, this called oligo DNA nucleotide or donor DNA. The role of this I have explained previously, further again I will explain. And the primer for screening, like what kind of mutation you want to create, so you need to design the primer for that screening. Surveyor assay kit, this is really helpful in this one, like you have no need to go for some RFLPA or something, just get this kit and do the surveyor assay and find out whether that required deletion or insertion is there or not, and the reagent and equipment for study. So once again I will repeat this, like this is a target region where we want to create some mutation. We will design the guide RNA to match at this region. So this guide RNA, this is a PEM site at three base pair upstream. There will be a cleavage. After that, a repair mechanism will start, and then repair mechanism, if it is homology direct repair, requires some template. That template will be our donor DNA. And this mutation, this like repair mechanism will incorporate approx 50 base pair upstream, 20 to 50 base pair upstream, and 20 to 50 base pair downstream. So we can design a donor DNA 40 base pair to 100 base pair, and we can put the desired mutation, whether it is a single mutation or some base pair deletion, in that donor DNA. So when repair mechanism will start, that donor DNA will incorporate in this one. And after that, we can again synthesize these cells, or we can propagate the cell number, and that desired mutation can be achieved. So this is just a study design. So like I have taken one single example, like if you want to generate some deletions in cell line using CRISPR-Cas9. So the first thing is, firstly, you need to go some in silico study, need to design single guide RNA and donor DNA, and also to decide that which vector we need to use. There are now multiple vectors are available for CRISPR-Cas study. So it depends that which study and with which method we are going to do our study. After that, the functional validation, we will transfect you taking this vector, we will transfect the cell, and after that, we will go for surveyor assay. So in surveyor assay, if that mutation is there, then it's okay. Otherwise, we need to repeat these steps. So what is surveyor assay? Like we have created some mutation in cells, and after that, we will extract the DNA from cells, and we will go for PCR using high fidelity proofreading polymerase. So if you know that Hercules polymerase is there, which have a very high processivity rate, so that enzyme can be used, and after that formation of hybrid DNA duplex. How this hybrid DNA duplex will form after this PCR in this one, like suppose that we have created a single point mutation, that mutated DNA will be there, and we will provide the normal one. We will have some control DNA in our hand. Along with that, we will set a PCR, and in that PCR, hybrid DNA duplex will form. And in that heteroduplex, we will do the digestion using surveyor nuclease. So this surveyor nuclease have the capability to find out that mismatch and cleave that DNA from that region. and that cleaved DNA we can study using agaro gel electrophoresis. So if it is homoduplex, like you have your controlled DNA, and after this PCR amplification, you have seen that, okay, there is no cleavage or there is no mismatch. At that time, homoduplex will form. You will not get any clipped form. But if some mismatch is there, surveyor nucleus will make a cleave, and we will get certain fragments. So this is a surveyor nucleus assay, which is really helpful in the identification of some indel insertion deletion mutations. So for generation of deletion in cell line in a flow chart, like firstly you need to select the cell line. Multiple cell line exists for, like, on an initial level, HCQ293T is a common one, which, like, if we will go for some reference study, most of time HCQ293T is used. But if you want to go for some dedicated one, like in a lung cancer, FI49 is common in use, in breast cancer, MCF7 or HeLa cell line. So it depends that what kind of modification you want to incorporate, that kind of cell line you need to choose. After selection of the cell line, single guide RNA will be designed. So there are now multiple tools are available. So for viewer, you can go for Zheng Lab. Zheng Lab, there are a lot of tools are available for getting your target, like single guide RNA or donor DNA or other thing as well, like primer for screening, you can get from there. So there is a tool, this ChopChop tool is from their site itself. So this single guide RNA, which will be designed using ChopChop tool, it consists of 20 mer proto-spear sequence upstream of an NGG sequence. So like here, I would just explain about my work, why I am talking about the CRISPR, or why this work is useful for me, or what we can do out of this work. So since sir mentioned that my work is to development of some novel molecule against lung cancer. So there are certain mutation in lung cancer whom I want to target. Unfortunately, cell line is not available for those mutation. So firstly, I want to generate those cell line for cell viability assay. So those cell lines I want to generate using the CRISPR-Cas system. So this is a study plan to creating those deletion. So the single guide RNA will be designed using ChopChop tool, consists of a 20 mer. Now at this step, you need to keep one thing in your mind, that there might be a multiple target. So you need to design at least 3 single guide RNA to check that whether your target or a single guide RNA is more efficient or not. Because like it may be or it may not be, getting off targeting is highly possible in this case. So at least 3 single guide RNA designing is recommended in this case. So cloning, in the next step, cloning into PX458. This is the vector which I have chosen. There is another vector available. So this is with the GFP tag when you want to use the FACS, fluorescence activated cell sorting. But if you are not willing to use some FACS, that time you can go for puromycin selective marker as well. So using BBS1 restriction enzyme in DS5 alpha strain. So till this point, this is a like common method which we follow in the cloning. So this single guide RNAs will be designed, and these RNA will be inserted into the vector, whatever our desired vector, and using BBS1 restriction site and T4 DNA ligase, we will go for cloning in DH5 alpha strain. After this, we will go for screening, and that can be done by design primer for deletion and non-deletion. So both type of primer we need to design, or we can go for this one, or we can go for sequencing as well. So after that, once we are confirmed, okay, the desired mutation or deletion is there in the DNA, we can go for the transfection. So for functional validation of single guide RNA, we will use HCK293T cell line. co-transfection. Now, why co-transfection? Because at this step, we will keep this thing in our mind. Also, we will use some liposome-mediated reason like the common in use, that lipofectamine. So, along with that, we will go for co-transfection. And we will create the deletion or indel mutation, which will be confirmed using surveyor nuclease assay, which I have explained earlier. After that, transfection will be done using CRISPR into A549 cell line for delivery of CRISPR-Cas9 plasmid. So there is a two-way pathway. Either like your gene is normal, it is not related to some particular disease or cell line is not available, you can create your desired mutation in the single cell line as well. And HEK293T is the model cell line because this is the most adaptive and easy to handle. Other cells are like, suppose that someone want to go for liver cancer. That time HUS cell line is there and it take more than 7 days itself in the generation or in the duplication. So in the lung cancer, A549 is common. So after getting this, I can do the transfection in A549. Following the facts for transfected cells for single cell isolation. So after this transfection, multiple cells will be there, approximately 0.3 million cells we need to do. And after that, we will go for single cell isolation to find out that in which cell transfection is happen and that mutation is. So those in single cell in a 96-well plate initially, we will isolate the DNA out of those 96-well plate. This might seem like lots of time consuming thing, but we need to go for that. So out of that 96-well plate, we will isolate the DNA and we will confirm by using the surveyor nuclease assay. After that, the cell in which it's confirmed that the desired deletion or mutation is there, further cell will be expanded and sorted in 96-well plate, round bottom plate. And after that, we will grow cell for 7 to 8 days. And after that, we can minimize and transfer in 48-well plate. When cell number will increase, we can transfer in 24-well plate. And following the cell number will increase in 12-well plate, 6-well plate. And at the end, we can transfer into T25 flask for our normal passaging and experiment. And after that, we can use for RT-PCR detection to check whether that mutation is there or not. We can store it in cryo. So this was all about the generation of deletion in cell line flow experiment. Now the basic component of this study. So in this, what are the components or what are the things which is important that I have explained further. So the expression system, different expression system is there. The one is the common transfection, which we can do the normally taking any liposome mediated reagent like lipofectamine. That will be transient type of expression only. But if we want to put some stable expression, like we want to create some stable expression and we want to generate some stable cell line, that time we need to rely on lentivector or lentiviral packaging system. So lentiviral transduction system is helpful in that case. Sir, am I audible clearly? Somna sir, am I audible clearly? Okay, so I think sir is not available. So in the different expression system, lentivector plasmid DNA is there. So this promoter driving Cas9 expression, it can be consecutive or inducible. While the U6 promoter is used for single guide RNA, the expression is common. So it can generate transient and stable both type of expression. It depends that following which kind of expression we want. Another is lentiviral transduction, in which Cas9 and single guide RNA can be present together in all in one vector. The third one is the AAV transduction. So this is compatible with only all in one vector, not with dual vector system. and another is Cas9 single guide RNA when you want to go for multiplex. Like suppose that I want to do like two different kind of mutation or two different kind of insertion or deletion. That time dual vector system is good. Now the mainly 2-3 steps are more important. So the deciding that which vector we need to use for our study and designing single guide RNA. So for designing the single guide RNA, as earlier I have mentioned that in the Zheng lab, we can go for chop-chop tool. So as you can see in the chop-chop tool, what you need to do, you need to take your target sequence. That target sequence you can paste. So when you will type or you will give the keyword chop-chop tool on Google, you will get this page. In this one, you can put your target, your sequence. And in this one, you can put that where you want to do in human or in plant, in animal, in insect, what, wherever you want to do, a list is available there. Using what CRISPR-Cas, so this chop-chop tool is helpful not only in CRISPR-Cas system, as well as in Talon or ZFN or Mega Nucleus. So you can put that one. And for which study, like whether you want to create some knockout, some insertion, some deletion, some point mutation. So after pasting your sequence, you will get this type of page. So in this page, what you need to do, you need to select your particular target. Like suppose that at 100 position, I want to create some mutation. So I will go at 100 base pair and I will select that target and I will get the single guide RNA sequence according to that. After that, with the single guide RNA, I will get the left and right primer for cloning that single guide RNA. So from these steps, we will select the target sequence for single guide RNA. Now, there is one like confusion that whether in single guide RNA, we should put PAM sequence or not. Because in, initially, there were some studies where they have put PAM sequence as well, those NGG sequence. But now there is no need to add the NGG PAM sequence because this NGG of PAM is used to select your genomic target. Like the target that viral DNA, what you want to target, NGG sequence will be there. So you just need to make sure that that NGG should be immediately followed where your target is there. So this is a kind of limitation. At your target, you need to find out that NGG sequence should be there. If NGG sequence is not there, it's really tough to target at that site. So NGG sequence should be there and it should be in the genome, but not the oligo which you have designed. So the actual oligo you should order is in that 20 base pair nucleotide, the CACC. I would like to highlight this point that you need to add CACC at 5 prime and C triple A at 3 prime. So these you need to add to create the cloning overhang. So this will create a cloning overhang. So this will be a gateway assembly type of cloning, which will bind this overhang region. So these are like an example of single guide RNA and single stranded donor template. For deletion, so single guide RNA top strand, bottom strand. So in top strand, 5 prime CACC you need to put, and in complementary triple AC in bottom strand, this overhang you need to design. And the donor DNA will be at that region where you want to create the mutation. So like suppose that at this T triple AA, this is the region where you want to create the mutation. And you want to replace it with the CCC. So in the donor DNA, at this region, you can put triple C instead of triple A. So when this donor DNA will incorporate during the repair mechanism inside the cell, that time that mutation will incorporate there. So this was all about what are the things or what are the flow you need to use for your study. Now for the preparation of expression construct in a brief, like firstly you need to generate the single guide RNA expression construct by PCR amplification. cloning single guide RNA into the desired vector with Cas9 nucleus, confirm the result by sequencing, also server assay for the detection of generated mutation. So this server assay, I have taken one reference from CRISPR manual at gene page. So this, you can see the cleaved mismatch product is there. So the server assay indicate that colony 3 and 6 were edited, while colony 2 wasn't edited and colony was the positive control, which was already edited. After the confirmation of these edited gene, it can be transfected or transducted and further propagated, like whatever you want to go for, whether transient type of expression or stable type of. This is the outline study in single guide RNA library construction and genetic screening will be done. So the PCR will be amplified. And after that, using Gibson assembly cloning, as earlier I have mentioned in single guide RNA, we can create this CACC or triple AC overhang. And following that, lentiviral packaging. This lentiviral packaging is helpful when we want to create some stable type of expression. So this pool infection, there will be isolation of untreated and treated. This can be checked by using a surveyor assay. Following the immunoblot of that surveyor assay, we can check that or they have checked that mutation is or not. And after that, they have drawn a pie chart there. Substitution mutation was 3%, insertion 6%, deletion was 91%. So this was a random study of approximately 73,000 of single guide RNA. And they have checked in the cell line, in the KVM7 cell line, whether what kind of mutation is more frequent in there. Or so they have found that deletion is more frequent as comparison to substitution and insertion mutation. Because the substitution and insertion mutation require the more specificity and more target specificity. After that, this which is done in Delhi itself in Dev Jyoti Chakravarti lab, this COVID test kit follow the FN-Cas9 editor linked uniform detection assay kit. So in this one, what they have done, they have taken nasopharyngeal swab containing virus. From that one, they have taken viral RNA and cDNA have been synthesized with that using Biotin primer. And after that, they have amplified the Biotin primer and taking those FN-Cas9 RNA polymerase with no mismatch in single guide RNA, another with mismatch in single guide RNA. Both been checked on gel and the signature, the cleavage one was confirmed and used for kit. And in that one, they have confirmed by given this gel pick and this been used in the paper strip. So what they have done in the paper strip, they have incorporated this viral RNA. In that one, if we will add the this whatever the sample we have collected, so that time this test band will give a single line. So this is the kit which wasn't in common use, but was a like evolutionary thing or evolutionary step in the COVID test. The second thing which make the this CRISPR more highlighted, the gene therapy for sickle cell anemia. So this Cas9 guide RNA was used for substitution mutation, single point mutation, which implanted in stem cell in patient. And after chemotherapy, they have found out that, okay, that mutation was recovered and sickle cell anemia patient was treated. So the conclusion of this study that because of CRISPR versatility and relatively low barrier of entry, the cost of gene editing is more accessible than ever before. This system and its variation have the potential not only revolutionize basic research across a wide variety of fields, but also the landscape of medicine itself. In theory, the CRISPR-Cas9 system is incredibly specific, but in practice, it is not. It can create mutation elsewhere in the genome known as off-target modification. So earlier I have mentioned this point, when you will go for theory, that time you will see that claim that there is a less off-target modification or no target modification. But when you will go for experimental manner, that time you will find that there are a lot of off-target modifications. So the CRISPR can be considered as a dual-use technology in that while it has an array of benefits to science, medicine, and public health, it also has the potential to be used maliciously, enabling the correction of detrimental genetic mutation that causes everything from cancer to Parkinson's disease. So there is a rumor kind of for the assumption that it can be used in bioweapons. So it does join a long list of powerful biotechnology tools. It lowers the barrier against biological weapon development as well. So there are the available online resource system for CRISPR-Cas system. So AdGene also provides some system, single guide RNA designer tool, Cas9 designer, ChopChop by Zheng Lab, CRISPR design also from Zheng Lab, CRISPR plant if you want to go for plant study, eCRISP, RGL tool, single guide RNA, Cas9 for your guide RNA designing, CRISPR multi-targeter when you want to design the multiplex, and CRISPR-Seq when you want to go for particular single guide RNA design. So after this, just with a single message that bacteria have revolutionized the science. So being a human, what you have done or what you can do, need to think about that. So that's all. Thank you so much, BioImagine, and thank you, Somnath sir, for providing me this opportunity.